Words to describe people. There are several ways of describing people in terms of work they do, the language they speak, the place they belong to, their family, their communities, and cultural practice. Let us see some of the words used to describe people found in Rigveda. There are two groups who are described in terms of their work. The priests, sometimes called Brahmins, who performed various rituals, and the Rajas. These Rajas were not like the ones you will be learning about later. They did not have capital cities, places or palaces or armies, nor did they collect taxes. Generally, sons did not automatically succeed fathers as Rajas. Read the previous section once more and see whether you can find out what the Rajas did. Two words were used to describe the people or the community as a whole. One was the word Jana, which we still use in Hindi and the language. The other was Vish. The word Vash comes from Vish. You will learn more about this chapter 5. Several Vish or Jana are mentioned by name, so we find reference to the Puru Jana or Vish, the Bharata Jana or Vish, the Yadu Jana or Vish, and so on. Do any of these names sound familiar? Sometimes the people who compose the hymns describe themselves as Aryas and call their opponents the Sas or Dasyus. These were people who did not perform sacrifices and probably spoke different language. Later, the term Dasha and the feminine Dashi came to mean slave. Slaves were women and men who were often captured in war. They were treated as the property of their owners, who could make them do whatever work they wanted. While the Rigveda was being composed in the northwest of the subcontinent, there were other developments elsewhere. Let us look at some of these. Silent Sentinels, the story of the megaliths. Look at the illustrations on the next page. These stone boulders are known as megaliths, literally big stones. These were carefully arranged by people and were used to mark burial sites. The practice of erecting megaliths began about 3000 years ago and was prevalent throughout the Deccan, South India, in the Northeast, and Kashmir. Some important megalith sites are shown on map page 13. While some megaliths can be seen on the surface, other megaliths, burials are often underground. Sometimes archaeologists find a circle of stone boulders or a single large stone standing on the ground. These are the only indications that there are burials beneath. There were several things that people did not make megaliths. We have made a list here. Try and arrange them in correct order. Digging pits in the earth, transporting stones, breaking boulders, placing stones in position, finding suitable stone, shaping stone, burying the dead. All these burials have some common features. Generally, the dead were buried with distinctive pots, which are called black and red ware. Also found are the tools and weapons of iron, and sometimes skeletons of horses and equipments and ornament of stones and gold. Was iron used in Harappan cities? Iron equipment found from megalithic burials. Left top, horse equipment left below, axes below a dagger. Find out about social differences. Archaeologists think that object found with a skeleton probably belonged to the dead person. Sometimes more objects are found in the grave than in another. Find Brahmagiri on map 2, page 13. Here, a skeleton was buried with 33 gold baits, 2 stone baits, 4 copper bangles, and 1 conch shell. Other skeletons have only a few pots. These finds suggest that there was some difference in status among the people who were buried. Some were rich, other poor, some chiefs, other followers. Were some burial spots meant for certain families? Sometimes megaliths contain more than one skeleton. These indicate that people, perhaps belonging to the same family, were buried in these same place, though not at the same time. The bodies of those who died later were brought into the grave through the those stones. Circles are boulders placed on the surface, probably served as signposts to find the burial site, so that people could return to the same place whenever they wanted to. A special burial at Inamegan on map to pay certain. It is a site on the river Goat, a tributary of the Bhima. It was occupied between 3600 and 2700 years ago. Here, adults were generally buried in the ground, laid out straight, with the head towards the north. Sometimes burials were within the houses. Vessels that probably contained food and water were placed in the with the dead. One man was found buried in a large four-legged clay jar in the country yard of five-room house, one of the largest house at the site. The center of the settlement, this house also had a granary. The body was placed in the cross-legged position. Do you think this was the body of a chief? Give reason for your answer. What a skeletal studies tell us. It is easy to make out the skeleton of a child from its small size. However, there are no major differences in the bones of a girl and a boy. Can we make out whether a skeleton was that of a man or a woman? Sometimes people decide to the basis of it is found with the skeleton. For instance, if a skeleton is found with jewelry, it is sometimes thought to be that of women. However, there are problems with this. Often men also wore ornaments. A better way of figuring out the sex of a skeleton is to look at the bone structure. The hip or the pelvic area of women is generally larger to enable child bearing. These distinctions are based on a modern skeleton studies. About 2000 years ago, there was a famous physician named Charaka who wrote a book on medicine known as the Charaka Sanhita. There he states that the human body has 360 bones. This is a much larger number than the 200 bones that are recognized in modern anatomy. Charak arrived at this figure by counting the teeth, joints and cartilage. How do you think he found out the human body in such great detail? Occupations at Inamegan. Archaeologists have found seeds of wheat, barley, rice, pulse, millet, peas and sesame, bone of a number of animals, many bearing cut marks that show they may have been used as food, have also been found. These include cattle, buffaloes, goats, sheep, dog, horse, ass, pig, sambar, spotted deer, black buck, antelope, hare and mongoose. Besides birds, crocodile, turtle, crab and fish, there is evidence that fruits such as bear, amla, jamun, dates and a variety of berries were collected. Look at the picture. Use this evidence to list the possible occupation of the people at Inamegan. Elsewhere, find China in your atlas around 3500 years ago. We find some of the first evidence of writing in China. These writings were on animals' bones. These are called oracle bone because they were used to predict the future. Kings got scribes to write questions on the bones. Would they win battles? Would the harvest be good? Would they have sons? The bones were then put into the fire and they cracked because of the heat. Then fortune tellers studied these cracks and tried to predict the future. As you may expect, they sometimes made mistakes. These kings lived in palaces in cities. They amassed vast quantities of wealth, including large, elaborately decorated bronze vessels. However, they did not know the use of iron. List one difference between the Raja and of the Rigveda and these kings. Imagine, you lived in Inamegan to 3000 years ago and the chief has died last night. Today your parents are preparing for the burial describe the scene, including how food is being prepared for the funeral. What do you think would be offered? Weather, language, hymn, chariot, sacrifices, Raja, slave, megalith, burial, skeleton, iron. Some important dates. Beginning of the composition of the Vedas about 3500 years ago. Beginning of the building of the megaliths about 3000 years ago. Settlements at Inamegon between 3600 years and 2700 years ago. Charaka about 2000 years ago. Thank you.